guy for about 10 years. He, you know, I used to ride in the 90s, and I got out of it after my daughter was born. And when she hit 16, I'm like, okay, she's old enough to take care of herself. So I got back into it, and he had been riding for, you know, several years. And he went on riding with us down 3090, that's in Waller County, White Houston. And there's a series of 15-mile-per-hour turns. At the meeting, we see 15-mile-per-hour, it means 15-mile-per-hour. Do not go over. Well, he navigated the first one good, accelerated, got up to around 45 or 50, didn't make the next one, broken collarbone, concussion, watered up his new R1. So he's like, hey, why don't you tell me about these track days? So he started doing track days. This is his first one.
It's on an R1.
It's on an R1, so he's not going to be in trouble with it. Third track day. This is a different bike. This is, he bought a track bike. This is a 2000 R1. He didn't wreck the street bike again. Carrying a lot more speed, but if you ever look at his body position, draw a straight line. Way too much lean for this turn. I think it was in the next session, he most sided wanted this bike up. He gets one of those guys that's fragile. But so he, you know, he calls me up and he goes, so what do you think I'm doing wrong? Go to the park, pictures and look at the pictures. He's showing you exactly what you're doing wrong. Your body position is just horrible. I see you need to wipe the inside head, drop that inside elbow, bring your head down. Next track day. Bring that elbow down, get the head down, upper body down, really weighting that inside peg. He started getting really fast this day. And he's one of those go-for-your guys, Grant, don't they forget about that, oh my god. Really pick up the pace, you know, for his body position got good. After 8 track days, his first CMR race, CMRA race, and finished in the top 10 on all three of them.
I know that guy.
You know that guy. So, I mean, look at that picture. I mean, that's almost picture perfect right there. He crashed that day.
Yeah, the next picture's in.
There seems to be a theme.
The body position. He's going into Big Bend at Crescent. Said he's going in too hot. He's full lean, and he just tapped the brake. So he was in fourth place when that happened. He was rolling out there. I said, he goes, I was scared to death out there. I've never been so fast in my life. I said, you had a group behind you. They were stuck. He goes, I know. I felt them. but you know, just one of those guys that comes natural. And yeah, this guy.
Oh, man. I know him.
Is that who I think it is?
That's exactly who you think it is. You know, this is his third track day. Friend of ours, he did his first track day here last year at ECR. Started out level 1, bumped up that day to level 2, pretty good pace. Body position wasn't too bad, understood the line. He decided he wanted to go to GSS at Houston. It's kind of like a 1.3 at Crescent, not real big, good small bike track. Told him not to go. He went, and on the very first session, he high-sided. And he hurt himself pretty bad, the bike was screwed. Yeah. Look at the line. Too much heads on the side of the line. A lot of lean angle. Got on the gas. Back in, stepped out. Like it this way. Get a little bit.